What's up, guys? What's going on? How y'all doing? We're back at it. Another video. So you guys know I already promised everybody we're gonna get the 240 going. So by saying that, we're gonna start getting working on this again so we can get in the car. If you guys don't know, I have a 1995 240SX Zenki edition that we've done like a lot of restoration work to. Pretty much everything, whole new body kit, all new brakes all around. We got the TriggaSpec intercooler kit for the LS. Everything, guys, this whole done up rear. The whole suspension has been changed. Let's see if this lighting gets better. The whole suspension has been fully changed. We got the interior all stripped, painted, super nice. Nice and sparkly. I don't know if the camera's gonna pick it up or not. But yeah, we've done all this stuff and we got a ton of more stuff too, obviously, that we did in house. Sorry, there's a bunch of shit in here. Fuel system, all that stuff. But anyways, so we're gonna get to the motor now, which is what we are gonna be working. Sorry about the mess. I have a ton of cars, ton of stuff going on. But we have our 5.3 liter LM7 motor, single turbo. We got the TriggaSpec turbo kit, our extra long coil harnesses that we built, twin collectors going to one, everything set up nice and correctly for this motor to be screaming very happily. Turbo sponsor Max Peating Rods. Thanks, I'm excited to use this, see what's up. You know, I've seen other creators use it and they get a lot of good responses. Well, anyways, so we got this motor and we're gonna be doing the steam port kit, which is pretty much these guys, this. And as you guys can see, the black of the motor is blocked. This is like a crucial part. You want it to be able to interconnect from all four corners going in and out. So as you guys know, I build my own stuff. So we went ahead and built one that we'll offer at TriggaSpec as well. But first, before anything, we gotta get this. Oh, I think I need both my hands for this. But let's take our Mondingo Holly sniper intake manifold off. And now that we have that off, we have what we call the valley exposed now. All right, so the valley is exposed. We have a Gen 3, obviously. Our NUKE sensors are right there. So I'll tape these off so nothing gets in. But we're talking about this whole assembly right here. This line going like that. And then this and that corner right there, which is this. Well, I'll show you guys now what I've developed and what we're going to replace it with. And I'll show you guys how to install it.
We're going
to
interrupt today's video from our sponsor, Kaiweets. First is the electronic tool, and then the second one, which I'm very stoked about, is this. This is one of those boroscopes, but the head actually moves. So let's check out what they sent us.
Right, first, we're gonna open up the two draw crimping set. This is the tool itself, and then these are the crimping heads for all different sizes. So just like this, I believe. So we got the teeth on. These are for 1, 2, and 3. So you guys can see it's spring loaded and then locks up. And then for release, there's a button right here. And this allows it to fully open back up. This is a must have. I'll be using these in all the videos. If you guys are interested and are an electrician guy for cars, house, whatever, this is 100% a must. Now on to what I've been really waiting for, this guy. Once you open it, there's this nice case on the inside. So check that out. Nice packaging, very, very nice. So inside the case, we got our Kaiweets boroscope. Check out the little head, there's a flashlight on it too. What's really cool about this knob right here, when you guys do this, check that out, it spins. So you don't need to pull it out and do it yourself. If you ever use one of these, when you go to do this little head, you have to pull the whole thing out in order to do it. We can test it out on Rafa and see how it works. So just some real world testing, check this out. Right here, head fully moves. This is awesome. So pretty much whatever you're trying to look at, if you wanna be able to look at it differently, like let's say right now, you guys see where the outside, and then it flips the images. Now if we turn the nozzle, the actual thing is moving. This is so cool. I've never had one of these, but this is very handy, especially if you want to inspect the cylinder wall inside your engine and you have this. You're able to go ahead and spin it while you take the spark plugs out,
rather to actually having to remove this from the engine and going through it again. This thing's very, very cool. I'm very impressed with this thing. Thank you, Kaiwitz, for sending me this and the crimper. I'll be showing you guys more in depth on how this works when we do the spark plugs and inspect the motor of our new truck. I want to just say thank you for Kaiwitz for sending me this and the nice jaw crimpers. Thank you for sponsoring today's episode. Appreciate you guys. If you guys are interested in Kiwitz product, hit them up. Links in the description. Their Amazon store. Check them out.
All right, so pretty much we got the kit right here. As you guys can see, we have our two stainless steel braided lines, steel fittings. These are crimped, as you guys can see. And we use a TriggaSpec PTFE hoses. So not nylon braided, nothing like that. Top of the line quality. We got these anodized corner vents right here. We got four of them, all new hardware. And then with this kit, you get the option if you want to just raw like this is fine, or if you want it heat wrapped like this, which I'll probably do, comes like that as well. But yeah, these kits right here is probably going to vary from like 150 to 170. I know it's not that much, but this stuff isn't really cheap to make either. Like, these are machined, these are all PTFE steel stuff, and top of the line, best of the best. But anyways, I'm gonna install this on the car. I'm actually gonna finish these up right now and then we'll install it. So now that our hoses are done, we got them heat sleeved and nicely buttoned up, we're going to begin installing these. But first, before we get to any of this, we're going to have to remove the stock steam ports on the engine. So there's four of them, 1, 2, 3, 4. I believe these are 10s, so let's get to take them off. Alright, so I managed to take all of them out. These are the stock steam ports. You guys can see they're just capped. These are the holes. This one ended up being stubborn and it was like messed up, as you guys can see. But this is a really good part right here where I always spend money on like tools and shit. And I buy stuff and I'm like, oh, I never end up using it, etc. But the time when it comes to use it, like this right here, for that bolt, it makes life so easy. So this is like a strip bolt set. It was a size 10. We grabbed it, slapped it on with an impact, bam, came right out. So super worth it, guys, when you have a nice, doesn't have to be crazy brand or shit, just when you got the proper stuff to do the job, life is so much easier. Anyways, so now that we got this stuff off, we're gonna go ahead and give this a nice cleaning, clean it up, make it nice, and then slap our new stuff on. All right, guys, so I went ahead and installed it. So the way to install this without getting into too many complications is one side at a time. I'll show you guys the front. You're gonna wanna tighten this down and then line it up to where the flat part of the fitting is lining the bolt. And I used some gasoline. Now I'll show you guys what I used, but this is pretty much how the rear looks. We'll have kind of the same similar look in the front right there. And then I torque these down to 8 foot-pounds, which is what we need to do. But yeah, now I'll show you guys the process of how to do the front. All right, so for the front, what we're gonna do is first we're gonna take the hose obviously itself, and I'm gonna slap the fitting on it and tighten it all the way down. And don't make it super tight because you want to line this up however you want to route this. This is good right there. But now, how do we want to route it in the front? We can always push this like this. This is on the bolt. I'll adjust the hose a little. I need to move this. But you guys get the idea. You pretty much are playing a game here of finding the best way to mount it. So I think this is pretty good. So on this end, I can come here now and see that the bolt lines up, and I can always pass one through. It's giving me a little nice area of where it can bolt. Now we're gonna do the same thing here. We're gonna go ahead and feed this on, come here,
and get this clocked in the correct position. Obviously we'll tighten this a little bit more, but it looks like in this position everything lines up nicely.
So you guys see, just like that, I jigged it up so I know exactly how I need to line up. Now you're gonna go ahead and remove this and we're gonna head over to the vise. All right, so we're back at the bench. So now a good idea, if you look at the fitting like this and you think about a clock, you can see that the fitting is pointing out towards like 1 o'clock. So when you're assembling this side, you remember when you look at it dead straight, it should be looking at 1 o'clock. Might be a stupid way, works for me every time. And as you guys can see, the other one, if you're looking at it as like a clock, it's pointing towards right around 11 or like 10 o'clock. So yeah, you just know 1 and 10. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and remove it. I like to usually use this paste stuff on anything I do. So put a dab of this on the threads and then go ahead and tighten it in the vise grips. Now when you tighten in the vise grips, remember when before putting in the vise grips, you want it to be pointing at the clock position that you originally started at. So when you do tighten it, it doesn't move and it gives you the most accurate installing. So just like that in the vise, I went ahead and tightened it, put some paste on it. Should be now we're gonna go ahead and recheck this side, just make sure it's good. All right, so we got the front set up and I'm gonna be running it towards the inside because we have our fuel rail going. So now we're gonna tighten it down, and pretty much you put one side in, tighten it down, and you want the flat side of the fitting facing the
bolt hole, so you can go ahead and tighten the bolt down.
Oh yeah, let's do it.
Pass the bolt through now for this side. And that's it.
It's the front connected now. Rear connected, everything's good to go. We'll throw the manifold on to test for everything. All right, looking good.
And obviously with the wrench, you wanna tighten these one more time. You can, you don't need to go crazy gorilla though. That came out good, looks good.
All right, so we threw the manifold on to test fit it. Everything looks very, very solid,
as you guys can see right there. And then we have our item right there that went all the way through.
Holley sniper intake manifold on top, and then now we got the rear as well right here.
Very nice. Our
air pressure sensor behind it, everything clears, looks very legit, very nice, came out very cool. So yeah, if maybe one of you guys interested, let me know. Obviously everything I make for myself I offer, so if you guys want one, you know how to get a hold of me. But yeah, that's how it looks. Came out clean, very, very nice. So next, we're gonna obviously, after this, we're gonna go ahead and refresh our trans. We got some new stuff coming for a new clutch fork, new clutch, everything. And then we got the LOJ swap stuff coming. So soon we can mate this to that. And then this whole guy needs a new pan and all that stuff. So yeah, we're gonna do some more work to this. And then this and this are gonna mate. And then these guys are gonna go ahead and walk over to go to the 240. But yeah, thanks for watching guys, appreciate it. See y'all in the next one.